I don't know why we're doing this. The title says people and you're a plant. Unfair. You're an enemy plant boss. Have you fought you? I was playing Metroid Prime. I was having a great time, okay? Until you showed up, and so I killed you, and then you just show up again. You are one needy motherfucker. Oh, here we go. Yep, here we go. I don't... Plants!
Brought to you by plants. They're nothing to sneeze at.
We literally cannot live without them.
Plants!
And apparently neither can video game designers, because I swear there is something plant-related in 99% of games out there. Sometimes they heal us, sometimes they keep zombies at bay, but most of the time, they destroy us. Here's a list of the top 5 deadliest plants in video games. Number 5, Kale Deimos from Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. Am I saying that right? Deimos? Boss of the Forbidden Woods, this guy's a real coward, sticking himself to the ceiling so Link has to use his little boomerang to cut at his tentacles to bring him back down to his level. Only to get violently eaten and spit out over and over again. Certainly no shortage of plant-like creatures in the Legend of Zelda series, but this guy just kinda rubs me the wrong way. Like, look at this. Isn't that cannibalism? I think that's cannibal. That's disgusting. Kale Deimos. Number 4, Flagra! From Metroid Prime. Oh look, it's just your normal average mutant plant who- OH MY F***ING GOD, WHAT IS THAT? WHY? Oh shoot it. Oh for the love of God, shoot it. So some really savvy landscapers thought it would be great to make this adorable guy the centerpiece of the Sun Chamber without realizing that eventually it would get mutated beyond all reason and try to eat everyone. And then, oh good, he's dead. We can all move on with our- OH HOLY F***ING SHIT BALLS, HE'S BACK. So it's a good thing that Samus eventually blows this thing to smithereens. Hey, I kill plants too. But not usually with bombs. Usually with my unwavering decision to not water them. Number 3, Plant 42 from Resident Evil. Plant 42 began a rapid growth shortly after it was exposed to the T-virus and evolved to the point where the original specimen can no longer be determined. Like, this thing could have been a pansy. A cute little innocent pansy, but no! Now he's another mutated ceiling plant. Why does this keep happening? In Umbrella Chronicles, let me tell you, Plant 42 does not go without a fight. And it's extra freaky because he kind of reaches out and grabs you and like shakes you. And in first person, that's kind of not okay. It's very frightening. But eventually you hit the right spot and the battle reaches its climax. Teehee. Number 2, the hyper-mutated flytrap from Bulletstorm.
The famous Venus flytrap.
Okay, call me a bro, call me a douche, call me an ASU grad, whatever. I thought Bulletstorm was great.
Rise and shine, birthday bear!
And this big hyper-mutated piece of shit plant not only earns the title of deadly because it's hard as hell to beat, but also because I nearly flung myself off a roof with frustration trying to beat it. So, like, double death. Like, in the game I die, and then in real life, I also die. That's deadly. Similar to our last guy, this boss grabs you in first person while you're strategically trying to slide around the room and shoot the weak spots whenever they make themselves available. I cruised through the rest of Bulletstorm with ease, but this guy had my number. That number is 5.
That was shitty.
And the number 1 deadliest plant in video games? Hold on. Poison Ivy's Deadly Plant Garden from Arkham Asylum. Come on, it's only fair I get to wear my Poison Ivy dress. Ivy already gets extra points for her deadly sex appeal, but this boss battle is by far one of the craziest plant fights I've been in since that time I got my leg stuck in a rose bush. True story. Very painful. There is a lot going on in this battle. First, you can't even directly deal with Ivy and her plant bitch because you're picking off cronies. Then you have to do some fancy diving to avoid the thorny roots shooting up out of the ground. When you finally get a moment's peace, you can throw the batarang at the center of Ivy's plant whenever she appears. Oh yeah, while she's shooting fireballs at you. But at least for such a dramatic battle, it has a pretty dramatic death scene. bitch had it coming. That's it for this week's top five, but wait! Wait! Ha! Fooled you! Come on, you really think I'd go through a list of top five video game plants without mentioning the piranha plant? So little faith. You know what? F*** it. It's my show. Let's shift everything down a number and give the number one spot to the piranha plant, not just because he's a jerk, but because he's a legendary jerk. Old Piranha has been chomping on us over and over and over since World 1, 2 in Super Mario Brothers in 1985. That's before I was born. Age already gives this guy rank. He's even proved himself as a decent boss several times in, for example, Mario Party DS, Yoshi's Island, and as Petey Piranha in Super Mario Sunshine. Piranha Plant, we'd never forget you. Keep on chomping. So wait, I guess that's 6 items on my list this week? Good thing it's my show and I do what I want. Suck it! That's really it for this week's top 5. Be sure to tweet all your love, hate, and respectful disagreements to @LisaFoyles. And, you know, I've been doing my best to respond to everybody, so keep them coming. I'm Lisa Foyle. See you next week for another top 5.